What up, YouTube? It me, your boy, Chris Simmons, presenting you with another episode of The Size of Our Shoes. Now, my studio space is still in absolute shambles, so the majority of this episode will be shot from a different room in my house. This will probably be the case for this week and maybe next week. Maybe the next couple, we'll have to see. In a sense, today's episode is going to be about animal agriculture. And in a sense, it's also going to be about something that's a very important thing to consider this day and age, using water responsibly. In some cases, water being wasted is a consequence of outdated industrial standards. In other cases, it's a result of fast fashion and the clothing that we wear on a daily basis. And in the case of today's episode, it's the sheer magnitude of water that's being used, polluted, and wasted for raising and producing livestock. I'm a wildly fortunate individual to come from a country and an area that hasn't yet faced water scarcity. I, like the majority of people in the developed world, can simply go to my faucet, turn it on, and get clean water for whatever I might need it for. But this is not the case for the majority of people on Earth. The Earth holds 326 million trillion gallons of water. 97% of that is salty ocean water, and 2% is frozen at the poles. That leaves just 1% fresh water, and it's not all distributed evenly. Canada, for example, has 10,000 times the amount of water per capita than Kuwait. And even if an area has access to fresh water, it's not guaranteed that it always will. Consider Cape Town in Africa. In 2018, after 3 years of unprecedented droughts, Cape Town faced a day zero event which would force municipalities to shut off the public water taps for its citizens. Between government restrictions and personal commitment to water reduction by Cape Town citizens, they were able to push off that day zero indefinitely. But with dozens of other world cities facing that same problem in the coming decades, it's only a matter of time before business as usual water use runs this world dry. Thankfully, with a modification to our diet, we can personally reduce the amount of water that we're responsible for on a daily basis. We can really start to understand the water footprint of the animals that we're eating by considering the diet of our diets. A water footprint is the amount of fresh water required to produce anything. There are three factors that go into the water footprint of food. The blue water footprint is the ground and surface water we use to make a product. The green water footprint is the amount of rainwater used on that product. And the gray water footprint is the amount of fresh water that gets polluted by creating that product. The water footprint of beef is 1,800 gallons per pound. I mean, think about it. If a cow is factory farm or feedlot raised, it eats a diet primarily made of corn and soy. And cows can put away between 50 and 150 pounds of that per day. If we look at some other animal products, we see a similar trend. Chickens, for example, are about 450 gallons per pound, and pork is nearly 600 gallons per pound. Now, if we look at various plant-based options, we see much healthier numbers. Tofu requires 302 gallons per pound. Asparagus is 283 gallons. Eggplant is 47. Potatoes are 37. And broccoli is just 16.
Oof. So, after all of that, the obvious answer is to stop eating so much meat. Anybody who's been paying attention to my story over the past couple of weeks knows that I have been on this journey to go vegetarian and to ramp up my way into actually going full-fledged vegan. You can watch the latest episode here or maybe here, and in that episode you'll be able to download a template that's been helping me stay on the right track. I've been able to plan my meals in a way that keeps it both possible and exciting. if you are planning on getting into it, which again, my suggestion is you absolutely should, especially considering the numbers. One, don't try and be a hero. You don't need to cut everything out at once. You can have a day or 2 days during the week where you eat meat or where you eat fish. But if the majority of your time is being spent without animals or animal byproducts, you will be making a huge difference. Two, make stuff that excites you, that you like. The most recent meal that I made, a peanut butter African stew, something that I've enjoyed eating for a long time, so I'll like really enjoy that. And number three, remember why we're doing this. Just think about the numbers while you're thinking about your next meal, and remember what kind of difference you can make. If you liked what you heard here today, I ask that you please like, subscribe, and share so that we can start getting this message out to as many people as possible. The fact of the matter is, significant change is impossible unless the overwhelming majority of society makes the choice to change. So I ask you here today, in what way can you change to forge a better future?